Hello all. Today we will be seeing the electrical stimulator. I'll be actually explaining you about this machine. We have completed the panel diagram of this machine, so I'll be actually correlating that this machine with the exact panel diagram that what we were having. To be very precise, this is an electrical nerve muscle stimulator, and very precise, this is a diagnostic stimulator. I hope that you can see it is written as electrostim DT. DT stands for diagnostic. This is not a therapeutic stimulator actually. I'll tell you why this is not a therapeutic stimulator at the end. Okay. So this is a diagnostic stimulator, but we are using it right now for even for therapy also. To start with, of course, this is the power cord, okay, the power cord that is having 5 amperes it requires. There are certain equipments in physiotherapy like shodidathermy which requires 15 amps, and you can see at the back of the one where the power cord goes in, okay, and so this is the power switch. Once you switch on, you can see that the green light goes. That means when the green light is on, that means the supply is there for the stimulator. Just one more thing that I want to include simultaneously is to here you can see below to that power cord, you can see this is a fuse. Yeah, you can see this is the fuse, and hope you can see that inside that there is a fuse is there. This is okay, this is actually called as a cartridge fuse. Okay, cartridge, you must have seen, you know, bullets, rifle, the guns, may they use cartridges. Okay, so this is a cartridge fuse. Right now I cannot show you that there is inside that there is a very thin line, thin metal wire will be there, and this is the fuse. And if by any chance the machine gets excess current, the fuse will blow. This fuse will blow, and most of the time when this light is not going on, is not switching it on, first thing that you have to do is this, just check this fuse. Okay, just check this fuse, probably that would have blown which you are not aware, and yeah, fair enough. So first thing you have to know is that there is a fuse is there, and this actually in that machine itself we have a replacement fuse also, generally they give you. So if it has gone, just remove it and put the replacement fuse and start work. Why? Because otherwise if you call for a service engineer, he will come after 2 days or something like that, and he will charge you, and till that time your machine will not be on. So that's a very important thing you have to know, is there is a fuse, most likely that's. Now okay, now let me start this stimulator. You can see here, this is the whole things. Okay, when we see the stimulator there, you can see there are basically two colors in this machine, a pink color and a blue color. The pink color circuit is entirely that goes for Faraday currents, and this blue current that goes for interrupted galvanism or modified direct current. Okay, first you can see here, right now this lamp is on, that means this part of the circuit is on, that is Faraday is on. I can choose with this button, once I press in, then this light starts to get on. That means now this one. So I can choose either of the circuit. This button helps me to decide that which circuit that I want to be working with, or which current that I want for my diagnostic and therapeutic purposes. So this is the current selector. I can choose Faraday current, or I can choose the modified direct or interrupted galvanic current. Okay, now let me start with the Faraday current. Okay, this Faraday current, this is again, it can be of two types. One is, it can be a plain Faraday current or a surge Faraday current. Here you can see that there is another selector is there. And once I switch on, you can see that there is no blinking of light. That means this is plain Faraday current. Means the Faraday current just switched on and it is going to flow uninterrupted. So this is plain Faraday current. Very rarely we use plain Faraday current for therapeutic purposes. So this is actually, this is not plain Faraday, this is interrupted Faraday. But we don't want to use that in an interrupted way. That's why we actually surge it. Surge means each and every impulse is going to increase in intensity slowly. So it is a kind of a ramp. Ramp of every pulse, not a single pulse. So this is, I'm going for surging. And here you can see there are two more things are there, knobs. This is surge. Actually, to be precise, this is surge duration. Means how much duration that I want the surge to persist or to work upon. This is, if I keep it here, this is the surge will be for a very minimum duration. Means if I set a particular intensity, say 10 milliamperes, within this time, minimum time, the machine will reach to the maximum of 10 milliamperes and will come down. And if I increase this, then it will take more time to reach that maximum 10 milliamperes again, that what I said, and will come back to zero. So this is surging duration. Actually, why we do surge is, surging is to produce a near normal voluntary contraction, means a tetanic contraction. So when I surge minimum, I'll show you this in practical, okay, with a model I will show you. So when I keep it in minimum, the tetanic contraction will come very fast and go down. And if I increase the duration, then the rate of contraction will be very slow and it will go very slowly up and then slowly come down. So this is surging. Surging is, and the next one is intensity. I hope you people remember what I talked about in the panel diagram. This is intensity regulator. Means in physics this is nothing but a rheostat, and in this machine patient becomes a part of a circuit. So that means this has to be a shunt rheostat, that is potential divider or potentiometer. So this is the Faraday current. If you look at this, I can choose Faraday current. Once I choose the Faraday current, I decide whether I want a plain Faraday or a surge Faraday. Once I switch on, that means I am choosing a surge Faraday. Then the next thing for me is how much duration I want the surge to be on. At present, I will say that keep it in medium. And this is the intensity regulator or intensity controller, and this I will increase the intensity till I get the required strength of muscle contraction, because it is a tetanic contraction, so I want to see a full visible or a strong contraction. Beneath to that you can see this is an output. This is the output, and you all know that this is black and red. Black is universally cathode and red is universally anode. But barring this machine has a difference that here red is cathode. That I will tell you how to test also, because cathode, that in the next sessions I will tell you that this is. But you remember, in this machine, red is cathode and black is anode. Universally, black is cathode and this is anode, universal. But this machine is a different. So this is all about the Faradic circuit. And you can see here something is in between the gray color where the selection area comes in. There also you can see that there is a pink and blue. And if you see here, niche, the below, it is written as resting time, okay? This is written as resting time, means if I am choosing this current, then the markings that are in the pink is applicable to this rotator. And you can see that resting time starts from 0.3, 0.5, 1 second, 2 second, 4 and 6 seconds. The ideal resting duration, that what it should be, how you should select is, how much is the surge duration? It should be longer than that. So when you are putting it for surge, you just look at how much time that the contraction is on, and then you increase the surge, that pink color, okay? You look at that, what is the surge duration, you keep more than that with your, this is resting time. Why? Because I don't want my muscle to go for fatigue. So increase the rest time so that the fatigue can be prevented. So this is about this.